Hey, it's day,
what day are we on? Day 13, sorry. And our declaration today is I am ransomed. You know, as I stated in the email, I think of the words, when I think of the word ransom, you know, we think of people who are very wealthy and maybe their children or someone being stolen or something of value taken and it being ransomed, and the perpetrator wants money or goods in exchange to give something back. And that's such a picture of what the enemy did, right? He took us. Because of one man's sin, Adam's sin, we died and we have death. And because Jesus came and he ransomed us. So the enemy held us in captivity, and Jesus came and paid the price. He ransomed us. He went through with the payment for the ransom so that we could walk free. So we could walk free. I can't even talk today. So Bible scholars enjoy debating the question, to whom did Jesus pay this ransom price? That's kind of an interesting question. Some say the devil. Others say God. Still others say it was done to satisfy the cosmic standards of justice. And I don't know whether that's cosmic, but it was God's law not to break. And so I believe we break God. My personal opinion is if you break God's law, it's God who we would pay. So such theological discussions are good. They're fine. But here's the bottom line. When we were captured by the enemy, by sin, and we were in death and we were dead in our spirits, God paid the unthinkable price by sending Jesus so that we could have freedom. John 3:16, right? For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever will believe in him would have eternal life. And so God paid that ransom for our lives. And so my question is what image comes to mind to you when you think of the word ransom? It's not a word that we use every day. With these images in mind, how does that affect how you think about Christ's sacrifice for you? Interesting. I'd love to hear your comments. Bless you.